I'm Sharon Nesbitt. This is the 43rd annual SummerFest Parade and celebration. The theme is a community that honors the past and embraces the future. The color guard is passing now. This is my associate, Diane White.
Hello, we're going to have a lot of good people here that worked really hard to volunteer. So our community came together and there's going to be a lot of fun today. We're going to be having, at Glen Auto Park after this lovely event, we're going to be having music, demonstrations, awards, pony rides, balloon sculptures, Home Depot construction, vendors, and Troutdale Rec Programs has arts and crafts for the kids. So stay tuned for the fun.
And this is the Multnomah County Sheriff's Office and the City of Troutdale.
We have Sheriff Daniel Stanton with the sheriff, and also we have Scott Anderson riding in the police City of Troutdale car.
And, of course, our Marine Patrol. We have a lot of water here on the Sandy River and the Columbia, and Marine Patrol is important to all of us for many reasons. And here comes the parade banner, by golly, Troutdale's 43rd annual SummerFest. We have been doing this for a long time. Our parade sponsor, Brasher's Auto Parts, and our presenting sponsor, the Port of Portland. And we have bagpiper Ralph Drew, who just recently became a registered nurse, so he has many talents. Thank you very much. I love that. And coming up next, our other sponsor, which is U.S. Bank in the Cherry Park Plaza. We used to have a bank right here in Troutdale, but it got robbed a lot. And behind that, coming up the road, is waste management. Always a standard here in the parade. And I believe that this is their natural gas powered truck, which is, of course, a really good thing. And then they have their recycling drill team coming along. We have recycling carts anyway. And that's Dean Camper right in front. They put the boss in the parade. Oh, that's a shiny truck. Isn't that a shiny truck? Does the one that comes to your house look like that?
No. But mine is clean.
The front of it looks like a bus. And the recycling teams.
Coming after that is Brasher's Auto Body. They say they can meet all your automotive needs.
And they have been, I don't know how many years they've been in this parade, but they've come back again and again and again. So we're really proud of their support. And look at that truck. Isn't that beautiful? Oh, a nice old Chevy pickup. Never saw one quite that shiny. And behind them, the very people who are bringing you this parade, MetroEast Community Media, which will broadcast the parade for people who didn't get to come. And I hear they have tattoos to pass out today. MetroEast Community Media. They take all of our moving pictures for us, right?
Yeah, they do.
And they better make me look good. And Julie's in that rig shooting the parade herself, I guess. She is indeed.
And coming up in a beautiful new Corvette is Fairview Mayor Ted Tostered. And he's joined by our own Troutdale Mayor Doug Doust. Nice car, Ted.
Okay.
That's brand new.
That is
very
pretty.
He just got that. Had to show it off today.
And behind them, Citizen of the Year, Norm Thomas, And Junior Citizen of the Year, Sophie Contreras. Congratulations to you too. Norm's a longtime city councilman, does all sorts of do-good stuff. Sophie is outstanding at Reynolds High and Center for Advanced Learning. And I am not sure where these cars are coming from. All I can tell you is they're really pretty. It is a lovely group of historic vehicles. Thank you for being here. Red seems to be the color of the day. Look at that. Okay. Thank you for being here. And we have a little gap in the parade, I think. Not to be unusual, because we have been lining up parade entries all over the side of this hill all morning, and so it takes a real effort to get them all in the right place. And this is Raggard E. Lee.
This is gymnastics, and they're located in Troutdale, and they have classes for all ages. They're recreational and competitive gymnastics as well. They do tumbling, cheer, and some homeschool classes as well. They pride themselves on their success and wonderful, talented young athletes.
And they're gonna, oh, there's a little girl. Oh. And they are going to do a routine. Regular elite gymnastics. Okay, now we gotta have them doing something. These are not on mats, these are on pavement. I hope this is gonna be okay.
So these girls are to BSAG level 2, and it goes all the way through level number 10.
Oh, that looks like they're having fun. Do you ever remember being that limber?
No.
Nice routine. Thank you, ladies. Thank you.
Very nice, girls.
Thank you very much. And here they come cartwheeling down the street. All ages. All ages.
Some talented girls out there.
I noticed most of them have their hands wrapped because they're doing this on pavement. Oh, my goodness, I love it. And coming up, I think those are the dads. Oh, wow. Here comes Dave Ripma's hay wagon, which blew a tire only a half an hour before the parade. and you are witnessing the miracle of the Troutdale City Council. Rittmer's a counselor. All the Shirley Craddock is on there, Tom Hughes of Metro, a whole bunch of politicians, and one banjo player, which makes it all work very well.
Larry Tom Hughes is the president of the Metro Council, and then we also have the Crops
Hi,
Program.
Rich so Allen Willamette
County
is up
Crops.
There.
Thanks.
We do have a...
Okay, we have Larry Morgan throwing candy.
And we have Frank Grundy on the back
youngest
playing,
council
too.
Council member in Troutdale right now. And in the back, we have Frank Grundy on the...
Smith Memorial Church is coming up. They have got a huge delegation in today's parade because they are 125 years old, all wearing matching yellow shirts, all ages, they said, from 2 to 98. Wonderful, venerable church in Fairview, just full of history, great and long-standing.
They have a brand new pastor, and his name is Grant Buskett, who will be swapping with them today. They want you to come and join in on their celebration events.
And then who do we have up next? Oh, honoring the past, embracing the future, Moore Smith Memorial Church. It is right on Fairview Avenue, used to be called Duck Lane in Fairview. Wonderful historic church. They have a spring luncheon that is not to be missed with great food.
And they're also having their 125th celebration. And they decided to come celebrate with us to enjoy that.
I wonder if they're going to be in church tomorrow. Wow, they got a lot of cars in the parade. Okay, Smith Memorial Presbyterian Church. Wonderful institution. It was founded by Red Shirt and Hannah Smith when they came to this country in pioneer days.
Now we have the Troutdale Lions Club, their members and their supporters. The Lion Float is provided by George Moreland Plumbing. And on there they have the Sam Cox Humanitarian of the Year, which is Jennifer Hoffman.
She has founded Emilio, honoring her son who was killed at Reynolds High School. She's formed a foundation and trying to make things better. And this is the Emilio Foundation behind.
She has organized many of these events to reach out to the young and the old alike. And she wants to make sure everyone feels the love and hears the message that she freely shares.
And behind them, the Deborah Messenger School of Dance and Rising Stars Preschool. They've been with us a long time, this group has. Thank you, ladies. Nice moves. And behind them, remembering that we have vendors at Glen Auto Park after this event.
There's quite a few vendors this year. It looks like there's about 50, so there's going to be a lot of interesting, fun things to look at after this event when you go down to the Glen Auto Building.
We've just seen a flag carrier for the Northwest Boxer Rescue sneak over and get a piece of candy. I think that is really good. The dogs seem not to want candy. They just seem to be enjoying the whole vista. And we have Messenger School of Dance doing a routine. Thank you, ladies. Very good.
Thank you.
done. Nicely done. Thank you. Now the boxers. Oh, they look fun. And Columbia Gorge Chiropractic. Perhaps they will help out down at the park after this parade is over.
We're going to have 10 four-wheeled ATVs, and those are being driven by the Alligator Shriners.
Oh, these guys are going to do shenanigans. They always do.
These Shriners are from Wilsonville, Oregon. Part of something that they do is they provide care for children with orthopedic burns, spinal cord injury, cleft lip, and palate needs, regardless of the parent's ability to pay. So a very noble cause, gentlemen.
And we will have them perform to the music of Brass Roots, which also participated here ahead of the parade. A lot of noise for six guys, don't you think?
They started in Portland in 2010. So they're all acoustic and they're very high energy. They like to play at street fairs, private events, fundraisers, and whatever you got going on, they want to be there.
Okay, that's wonderful. Nice group, nice group. Brass Roots.
Gresham Fire Department with fire engine number 75, also followed by the rescue boat, also number 75.
This is our local fire station, and all of the 9 firefighters there are also trained in swift water rescue, so good to know.
And if anybody wanted to know, they can carry 500 gallons of water, and they have over 3,000 feet of fire hose on that truck.
That fire station's been here since, some mid-1970s, something like that? We've had it for a long time. Right across from the post office. Okay, that boat looks fun. Both of them.
How many gallons? 750 gallons.
There we go. I suppose he's required to know that. And the next group up is the Awana group from Open Door Baptist Church. They have been in Troutdale for 35 years. They have an Awana club up there at the Open Door Baptist Church.
And they have a lot of kids that participate. And they do fun stuff like have dress-up theme nights, and they memorize their scripture and teach.
And there they are.
Yeah,
how
they
nice.
Have a lot of fun.
Hi, welcome to the parade. And behind them, U.S. World Taekwondo, right?
Yes. They're located at Cherry Park Plaza, and they're proud to be the recipient of the Best Martial Arts School by the Gresham Outlook this year.
Oh, look, and they're all sizes. Look, some of them are really tiny.
They say they're also home to the Taekwondo champions, Michelle and Jordan Ortiz. Good job, guys.
Nicely done. And behind, oh, here we are still. Now we're looking at Pitties in Pink. This is an attempt to make pink pit bulls more irresistible by Multnomah County Animal Services.
Yeah, because they are intelligent, they're loving, they're really nice, loyal family dogs. But since they have a bad rap, they're dressing them all nice and pretty in pink so you can see how special they are.
And then you talk somebody into wearing a pink dress skirt. Nicely done. I think we've tamed all of them. Pitties in Pink. And coming up next, advertising the opening of the King of Roads exhibit on the historic Columbia River Highway at the Troutdale Harlow House and Park. Greg and Sue Handy in, I forget what year it is, 53? We got honked at. I used to enjoy being honked at by a car like that. She's not giving me, I can't read those numbers. 57? 57. Thank you. A couple of years off on that. 1957 convertible.
And after that, we have Top Flight Gymnastics, and they are the proud award of the commercial for Lieutenant William Broughton as part of the expedition led by Captain George Vancouver. So we're proud to give this prize to...
Yeah, there they are with their trophy, by golly. Top Flight Gymnastics.
Congratulations.
So they're very happy.
And now we have the Super Kids Resale. I always wanted to go to that. You guys have your next big consignment event September 24th to the 27th at the Old Target on 122nd, and you say you have over 1,000 amazing bargains like clothes, toys, baby gear, books, movies, outdoor toys, and all sorts of stuff. So they really like you to check them out.
We're followed by Reynolds Youth Soccer. Happy to have them here. Soccer is particularly good this year. And they have bubbles. And then, Vacation Bible School.
So we have River of Life Lutheran Church.
And I believe they're up in Cherry Park Plaza, right?
Yeah, they've been serving Troutdale for over 15 years.
Very pretty float. Thank you. Very pretty float.
And their Vacation Bible School is for ages 3 to 12 years old. So they'd like you to join them if you have any kids that are that age.
And their Little Fishes Preschool follows that. And that's been 11 years that they have been in Troutdale. And the Little Fishes are all in a fishing boat. That's a good idea. And then we're coming up recognizing that Troutdale has been a tree city USA for what? How many? More than a decade. It's longer than that. 19 years. Recognized by the Arbor Foundation.
So these are some of the people from our City of Troutdale Parks Advisory Committee. One of the many committees that you could volunteer at or in Troutdale.
And then we have Walker's advertising our cruise in here on August 2nd, where we fill this street with more old cars. This is John Wilson, city councilor, with Chris Gorsuch, and that the next Corvette. You heard the Corvette. Restored by John and his father. Isn't that a lovely thing?
Yeah, he wants to make sure you know that his car is loud.
Yeah.
We can hear you, John.
And behind them, a 100-year-old 1915 Ford. Exactly a century old, that car, and still rolling for us. John Davis and Neskia Camerson. Isn't that a lovely thing?
And then we have Reynolds High School Theater, and you guys are the winners of the overall award.
Yeah.
The Captain John Harlow Award.
And they're doing Pirates of Penzance, and so the Raiders are aptly named. And they have received that award. Oh, that's great. Behind them, world champion Taekwondo.
They're in Gresham in their School of Martial Arts, and they have a lot of different ages that working to achieve all their goals, gaining some self-confidence and making friends or to become just more peaceful with yourself.
And here is our community award winner, Jeremy Hoyt's two entries. Major Hoyt is driving the World War II Army truck. Major James Hoyt.
Congratulations.
And they're the community winners. And then I believe one or both tractors. Well, one tractor. I'm not sure which tractor is part of that unit.
And that's the Clara Lateral Larson Award.
Wow. How nice. Nice community award. Thank you very much. And another John Deere tractor coming up for us. And you can always tell it's a John Deere. That's why we call it the Johnny Popper. Isn't that a nice noise? Wonderful. Thank you. And behind them, I think this is a, I forget which year Dave Ripma's Mustang is. Driven by Dick Goldie, 60. Advertising the King of Roads exhibit opening today.
66.
That exhibit opens today in the barn at Troutdale. And after that, the Members Union for Reynolds School District.
They represent our secretaries, bus drivers, custodian cooks, and educational assistants.
And they have Tootsie Rolls.
And they have lots of candy.
They have Tootsie Rolls. And then a car from, two cars from Gresham Ford coming up. Two cars from Gresham Ford. Nice to have them here. Ford is a sponsor of the highway exhibit because Henry Ford's Model T was one among the earliest cars on that road. And these walkers behind them are from Cherry Park Plaza. Nice to have them here. And then do we hear a really big band?
We do, and it's The Beat Goes On.
Yeah. So you're never too old. If you have played in a high school or a college band or any other organization, you can still continue to march and play with The Beat Goes On.
Their ages range from 20 to 80 years old. It looks like they have a lot of fun.
They have baton twirlers, they have a flag team. They just do everything, and they seem to have so much fun. We might remember this is a very hot day, and those people are gonna make this whole parade route. I think that's wonderful. They're gonna get their workout today. Goes on.
They've got everything, Sharon, between the batons and the flags and the dancing girls.
Thank you. 43rd annual Troutdale Parade, polished off by Multnomah County Sheriff's Office car. And to a reminder that our shuttle operates all day, taking people to and from the park.
And also reminding you that this party is not over, so head on down to Glen Auto Community Park, guys. You'll have a lot of fun.
Okay, you've just seen the 43rd annual Troutdale SummerFest Parade. I'm Sharon Nesbitt. I think I've been here for 20 of them, and MetroEast has been right here with me.
And I'm Diane Castillo White, and I've surely enjoyed this day. It was a wonderful parade, and we still have a whole bunch of activities going on at Glen Auto Park, so the fun is not over.
Thank you for being with us. Pleasure to have a whole town full of parade.